Welcome to the Mount Zion First African Baptist Church of Charlottesville, Virginia. On behalf of Pastor Dr. Alvin Edwards and First Lady Minister Barbara Edwards, we welcome you to this worship experience. We know that prayer still works, that the effectual and fervent prayers of the righteous can move mountains. Join us on every Thursday evening at 7 p.m. for our online prayer service. You join the service by dialing 701-801-6067. No access code is needed. We look forward to you joining us. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button in the description box. Happy Mother's Day to all of those who serve in this very special role. May God bless you richly. Today we are blessed to have Reverend Dr. Savola Monroe share the Word of God with us. A Mother's Commendable Faith, from Matthew 15, verses 21 through 28.
Thank you for watching over me. All of the sleepless nights you lay awake. Thank you for knowing when to hold me close and when to let me go. Thank you for every stepping stone and for the path that always leads me home. I thank you for the time you took to see the heart inside of me. You gave me the roots to start this life, and then you gave me wings to fly, and I learned to dream because you believed in me. There's no power like it on this earth, no treasure equal to its worth, the gift of a mother's love. Thank you for every sunlit day that filled the corners of my memory. Thank you for every selfless unsung deed I know you did for me. Thank you for giving me the choice to search my soul till I could find my voice. And I thank you for teaching me to be strong enough to bend. You gave me the roots to start this life, and then you gave me wings to fly, and I learned to dream because you believed in me. There's no power like it on this earth, no treasure equal to its worth, the gift of a mother's love. I thank God for a mother's love.
I can remember as a child back in Liberty, Texas, at 131 Navigation Street, at my grandmother's house. May me Sip Baldwin. Mama is what we called her. And I can remember on Sunday mornings, if you were in Mama's house, you had to get up for Sunday morning prayer.
Well, good morning, Mount Zion First African Baptist Church and friends and visitors, all who are watching online today. First of all, I want to thank God for each and every mother all across this world. But especially, a shout goes out to all the mothers in Mount Zion First African Baptist Church. And I hope and pray that today is a very special and meaningful day to you. Yes, even in spite of being isolated and confined, I pray that it's a great day for you, for I thank God for all the mothers of our church as well as in our community. And so I greet you in the name of Jesus the Christ, the Son of the true and living God. And I want to welcome you for joining our worship service this morning. We thank you for your continued support and your continued presence. And again, happy Mother's Day to all who are alive. We salute you, because the badge of honor goes to those who've already gone on before us, as well as the ones who are living today. May God bless you real good. And now, I want to introduce our preacher for this morning. Our preacher is Dr. Savola Monroe. Today is the day that Savola would have graduated from Virginia Union School of Theology in Richmond, Virginia. I should say Samuel DeWitt Proctor School of Theology in Richmond, Virginia. But nonetheless, she earned her doctorate of ministry degree, and I'm so proud and honored to introduce her today. She's a mother, she's a friend, she's a good sister in the Lord, and I thank God for allowing our paths to cross. And so I'm going to read the scripture right now, and then she'll come and share with us from the Word of God. If you have your Bibles, I would invite your attention to Matthew chapter 15, verses 21 through 28. And I'm reading the New King James translation. Again, chapter 15, verses 21 through 28. And here's what it says. Then Jesus went out from there and departed to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came from that region and cried out to him, saying, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, Son of David. My daughter is severely demon possessed." But he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she cries out after us." But he answered and said, "I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." Then she came and worshiped him, saying, "Lord, help me." But he answered and said, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs." And she said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered and said to her, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." And her daughter was healed from that very hour. Dr. Savola Monroe.
Good morning. And again, let me just focus again on verses 27 that says, "And she said, Yes, Lord, yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered and said to her, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." And her daughter was healed from that very hour. I want to offer this morning as a topic for this sermon, a mother's commendable faith. A mother's commendable faith. Please bow with me for a word of prayer. Eternal God and Father, it is again that you have allowed us to come before you, O God, and hear what thus saith the Lord. I ask you now, O God, as we prepare and have prepared for this day and for this time to come, that you will now just speak through me, O God, that hide me in your bosom, only that they would hear and receive only what you are given to be heard and said. We thank you now, God. We bless you, we lift you up, we magnify your most precious name. In the name of Jesus the Christ, I pray. Amen. A mother's commendable faith. Our text today is an outstanding and inspiring testament of a mother's commendable faith. It's a mother's faith in action. In this text, there is a remarkable quality and depth of faith that is demonstrated by an unrelenting, persistent, and insistent mother. This mother's active faith captures Jesus' attention and receives his astounding commendation. For he announces to her, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." Oh, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord and Jesus, our Savior, for his enduring mercy and his amazing redeeming grace. You see, Jesus, the author and finisher of faith, commends the faith of an unknown, a nameless, a Gentile mother who just will not go away, who will not be silenced or stilled without the healing blessing that she seeks for her child. Now, can't you just imagine the relief and the joy, the deep joy that this mother must have experienced when the Son of David, Jesus, said to her, "Let it be to you as you desire." Her petition has been heard and her petition has been granted. Her child would be healed. I imagine her song and dance went a little something like this. "When I rose this morning, oh, I didn't have no doubt, because I knew that the Lord would surely bring me out. So I fell down on these little old knees, and I asked the Lord to help me, please. And you know what? I got up singing and shouting victory. So yes, victory is mine. Oh, victory is mine. Victory is mine today, because I told Satan, 'Get thee behind me.' And now a victory is mine." So you see, our text presents a mother whose faith will drive her to the ends of the earth to save her child. And even if she has to be the subject of resentment, of humiliation, indignation, name-calling, and the like, she will sacrifice her self-esteem for the sake of her daughter. Her attitude is, "I'll do what I gotta do, and I'll be what I gotta be, if that's what it takes to save my child, even if that means eating the leftovers, the scraps, the fragments, the crumbs that fall from the master's table. I'll just have to be a crumb-snatching, crumb-eating mama. Oh, shucks, I ain't too proud to beg. My child's life is at stake." So you see, this is the essence of this mother's faith that is commended by Jesus. It is a faith that is anchored in her trust and her belief in God. It represents a mother's faith that says, "Yes, I can," when everybody around her is saying, "No, you can't." It's a mother's faith. A mother's faith says it is possible when circumstances and conditions all around her say it is not possible. A mother's faith will say there's got to be a way when others will say, "Oh no, there ain't no way." A mother's faith, I tell you, will not give up until she receives the blessings that she receives, that she seeks, I tell you. Yes. Even if she has to be like old Jacob and wrestle with the angel all night long. You see, bottom line, this mother's faith drives her to the point of not stopping until she gets the desired result. Well, do what you will to her, at least try to. And say what you will to her at your own risk. But for the sake of her child, she will not be moved nor stopped.
Say so.
And so I say to you today, as we celebrate our mothers, that I believe that mothers in this nation and around the world will be inspired and encouraged by the commendable faith of this Gentile mother. For although I am certain there are happy and smiling and beautiful faces in our midst, and God bless us all, but the thing of it is, all is not well in the land of motherhood. Because there exists the grim reality that our children are under the attack of the enemy. As such, many mothers are struggling to hold on, suffering and emotionally bruised and battered from fighting the life throbbing and robbing battles that are claiming the lives and the potential of our children, suffering because they are worn, suffering because we're torn, suffering because we're battle weary from fighting unjust, oppressive, and life-devouring systems. Oh, we're tired of it, I tell you. Oppressive situations, social situations, economic, political systems, systems that place emphasis on skin color instead of the content of character, systems that are unkind, systems that are cruel instead of being caring and compassionate. Systems that rather let them eat cake and die instead of helping to provide healthy, wholesome meals and help them to have access to affordable and adequate health care. Systems that place money and politics over principles and morals and ethics. Systems, I tell you, that seek to tear us down instead of building us up. Mothers are suffering because their children are caught up and entangled by the lures of this world. Some being the victim and some being the perpetrator, and some of them both. Mothers watching their children slip away from them, captives of prisons, of captives of graves. Mothers are hurting and crying out, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on my child. Mother and child are tormented. Mother and child just as tormented as the mother and child of this text. I tell you, we're in the midst of some ugly stuff. We are yet in the midst of just flat out spiritual warfare. For you know the text, we wrestle not with flesh and blood. We are warring against the spiritual hosts of wickedness, powers and principalities in high places. So mothers are hurting because children are going astray. And children are hurting because, unfortunately, some mothers are going astray. Perhaps it stems from too much of the world in our affairs and not enough of the word in our affairs. This is not an indictment against mothers, for we come here today thankful for our mothers, and we offer praise and encouragement. Yet even so, we realize that mothers were never meant to carry the banner of parenthood alone. Yet unfortunately, far too many are doing just that, trying to be mother and father in the midst of a world gone astray. But thank God. Thank God there's always a God, and thank God there's always a but. All praise and glory to God, I tell you, for all is not lost, for there is another reality, and that reality is the greater reality, and that greater reality is that we have a Redeemer. Oh, yes, we do, I tell you. He is our Savior. His name is Jesus. And Jesus, and Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord, for our God, Jesus. Jesus loves us. Hallelujah for Jesus. He hears our prayers. He intercedes for us. He forgives us. He heals us. And yes, he reconciles and restores us. And therefore, our hope is in the name of Jesus, the Son of David, that his mother cries out to, and who in turn commends her faith. So the question becomes, why? Why does Jesus commend her faith? In other words, what was it about her faith that made it praiseworthy to the extent that Jesus describes it as great faith? Well, I suggest to you 2 points to ponder regarding her commendable faith. The first point to ponder is that it was faith that was undergirded by an incredible degree of persistence. Persistence is that tenacity to endure. It is to be determined. It's a resolute determination to withstand the odds, to not give up, and to stand your ground in the pursuit of what you seek or desire. Now, let me make it clear that I am speaking about pursuit of what that is good. I know that sometimes folks get a little twisted and get just as determined about pursuing stuff that is not good as they do about that is which is good. But that's another sermon for another day. I'm talking about pursuing that which is good. And this mother's persistent, praiseworthy pursuit is for the good of her family. Yeah. And I would suggest to you that her persistence began even before she met Jesus. Her persistence, her determination began when she resolved to get help for her daughter. Bear in mind that this mother has been carrying a mighty, mighty heavy and burdensome load. She was consumed with overwhelming grief, intense distress, and gut-wrenching agony. feeling helpless as she stood by and watched her daughter be tormented day after day and night after night, tormented by an unrelenting satanic attacks. The text doesn't tell us exactly what manner the demon is torturing her daughter. The demonic behaviors aren't described. But based on this mother's crying out to Jesus that her daughter is severely demon-possessed, we can deduce that her daughter is definitely in a critical condition and perhaps even near death. We can also deduce that she must have been fed up with those little G-guards. Y'all know them little G-guards of her ancestors, for obviously those little G-guards had not done one single thing for her or for her child. But then she heard that Jesus was in the region. Now, how she knew, we do not know, because Matthew's account of this incident does not say. But if we look over in the 7th chapter of Mark's account, his account informs us that Jesus entered a house and wanted no one to know, but he could not be hidden. So this mother heard, she believed, and she went. She went to see the man that she had heard about, and she pressed her way through the crowds, just like that woman with the 12-year issue of blood who said, "Oh, if only I may just touch the hem of his garment, I will be made well." Likewise, here comes this mama pressing forward to have just a little one-on-one, a little encounter with the one whom she had heard about. This man from Galilee, whom is called the Son of David. This one whom she has heard about, who was going around healing the sick. Oh, he was causing the lame to walk and the dumb to talk and causing the blind to see. And oh, yes, what really got her attention? Oh, she heard he was casting out demons. So what we do know is that she put her faith into action and she headed out to find him who she sought. And being found, she boldly yet humbly approached. She fell down on her knees and she cried out, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, O Son of David, for my daughter is severely demon-possessed." Oh, yes, she called Jesus out. She called him by his name and she called him by his lineage. She knew his royal heritage. She acknowledged who he was and submitted to him as Lord 3 times in this text, verses 22, 25, and 27. And now her persistence is kicked into high gear because her faith is challenged not only by the disciples who are urging Jesus to send her away, but also by Jesus himself, who seems oblivious to her demands. But behold, this is a mother of great faith. Getting rid of her will not be so easy. And just so you get to hear the voice of her, to hear her persistence, I want you to hear this and how her persistence may have sounded at that time. I think it may have, imagine this. It goes a little something like this. "You can turn your back on me. You can tell me to go away. You can ignore me or whatever you want to do. Do whatever you got to do. Take your best shot. I'm already at my lowest point, but I'm still here. And I'm not going anywhere until I get what I came for. I'm here interceding on behalf of my daughter, and I will not give up. I will prevail because I must prevail. My daughter is dependent on me. So I will be the persistent in my request. I will be persistent in my deliverance and bugging you and nagging you. I will not go away, so you just as well stop trying to send me away. I will not let anyone take this opportunity from me or get in my way, not even if your blind disciples who think they know what they really obviously do not know try to get up in my way. But I know, because I heard that salvation is free to all, and the Son of David is no respecter of person. And anyway, I've been keeping a listening ear, and I'm getting a better understanding about this principle of salvation for all. It's for everybody. It's for Jews and Gentiles. So I know that if the dough of the first fruit is holy, then the crumb is holy also. Bottom line, if the crumbs on top of the table are holy, then so are the crumbs and the tippets that fall from the table. They are holy too. My attitude is like this. My attitude says, if crumbs and scraps from the table is still food, and little by little and from faith to faith, I will be filled and my daughter will be healed. So I'll eat the crumbs from the table until I can do better. At least I'm eating and I'm getting healed. Some of you still blind, dumb, lame, and hungry. My Lord, that's her voice. So her persistence gets Jesus' attention. Actually, she had his attention from the moment she pleaded for mercy. But I tell y'all one thing. I'm going to tell you this. This here mama sure enough is a mama, bad mama jama. Here she comes a begging for a blessing and has the audacity to get feisty and technical with the one holding the trump card. Yet her faith, her humility, and her persistence get her a victorious outcome. And this is an encouraging lesson for all of us. Let's move on. The second point to ponder is that not only was her faith persistent, this faith points souls to Christ. Jesus, captivated by her persistence, highly esteems her and says, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you desire." And in that instant, in the twinkling of an eye, the healing power of Jesus' words transcended distance. Jesus never left his location. He spoke and it was done. Jesus did what he had seen his daddy do when his daddy spoke. And the heavens and the earth were created because God spoke it. So like Father, like Son, by the power and authority of his spoken words, that tormenting demon was zapped back and went on through the gates of hell where it belonged. And the text says that the woman's daughter was healed from that very hour. Now, although our text doesn't explicitly say so, the rest of the story is that the Gentile mother and her daughter became witnesses for Christ, pointing souls to Christ. Oh, sure they did. Do you really think they kept this wonderful miracle to themselves? Do you really think they could even keep it to themselves? Oh, certainly not. Furthermore, notice on this occasion, Jesus did not say to her, "Don't tell anybody." Not that his recipients usually obeyed him anyway. But I suggest to you that this restored family became witnesses for Christ because they could not keep any of this to themselves. They had to go and tell somebody. They could not keep it all locked up. Mama told all who would listen that she went seeking and that she went and found. She asked and it was received. She knocked and the door was open. All of that mama went out and told, and so did her daughter. She told those ones who was around her. I imagine they told family, friend, and foe alike to come and see that man. Come see the man from Galilee. Come see this man, Jesus, the son of David, who had shown them mercy, the one who had looked beyond their faults and saw their need. This man called Jesus, the same one who says to us, "Come unto me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." This mother's commendable faith of persistence pointed souls to Christ. In her story, we find hope. We find blessed assurance and encouragement to keep pressing forward and never give up. Stories such as this offer promise and hope that trouble don't last always, that God is yet on our side, and that there is power and healing in the name of Jesus, and that faith is not dead because the author and perfecter of our faith is not dead. As the angel said, the tomb is empty. He is not here. He is risen. He is risen. He lives, and so do we. And because we live, and because he lives, we all can face our tomorrows. So again, I say to you, happy Mother's Day. And remember, this applies to all of us. We've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord. We're trusting in his holy name. He's never failed us yet. Oh, yes, we've come. We can't turn around because we've come this far by faith. Amen, and to God be the glory.
We have just heard a great word preached about having a commendable faith. And I want you to know that she, that lady, was not the only one who could have a commendable faith. for everyone who is listening to me right now, if you don't have a faith or a commendable faith, let me tell you how it can happen. It begins by you believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. And it's not about your religion. It's about having a relationship with a personal Savior. And that's what Jesus is offering himself this morning. And that's what the lady was pointing to in her own life when she was seeking help from Jesus, because she had a relationship with him. And so she was persistent, and she was also pointing to him that he had the answer. And I just want you to know today that the answer for COVID-19 is not in the White House. It's not in the State House. It's not in the House of Representatives or even the House of the Senate. But I believe it's in Jesus. And I just want you to know that that same answer for COVID-19 is also the answer for your life. For if your life is without direction, if your life is without hope, if your life is helpless, I want you to know that the commendable faith this lady had, you can have it too. All you have to do is to believe on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You have to believe he died and God called him back to life. Mark says, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. In just a few seconds here, I'm going to bow and pray and ask you to pray along with me. If you don't know him in the pardon of your sins, you can become a Christian today. And then if you're looking for a church home, I would highly recommend Mount Zion First African Baptist Church, 105 Langford Avenue, Charlottesville, Virginia. As I tell people here, we're not perfect, but we know the perfect one. But if you've not accepted him, bow your heads with me right now and pray this prayer. Lord Jesus, the Son of the true and living God, I recognize and realize that I'm a sinner, that I come up short, that there's nothing I can do to save myself, but it's by your grace and your mercy. And so, Lord, on this day, I ask you to come into my heart, because I believe in you, I'm trusting in you, and I want to be baptized and have an authentic relationship with you. Thank you for receiving me as one of your sons or one of your daughters. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer, I want you to go to your phones and call 434-293-3212. Again, 434-293-3212. And if you would leave your name and a number, we will get back in touch with you on Monday morning. Because this is just the first step to becoming a Christian and remaining a Christian. And so I invite you to come on this day. Thank you. And now may God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth, now, and forevermore. Let us all say amen. God bless you again. Happy Mother's Day, and have a good day.